Ladies and gentlemen, what's going on? It is your boy Noah Jones, and this is Today in Hip Hop. Today's episode is sponsored by NoahJonesNews.com, home of the hottest artists with the hottest motherfucking verses. There's 11 albums on there for you to check out, more or less. There's music videos, there's radio station interviews, there's some exclusive merchandise. There's also some free shit on there. If you type in your email address and you join the mailing list, you will get a free album instantly that you can download to your smartphone and start enjoying the content right away. Today's episode is going to be a little different, y'all. Today, we're going to do a little storytelling. I want to tell you about something specifically that happened to me. This is recent, and it's a classic example of how your friends are the main ones that hate on you. Okay? Your friends are the main ones that will slow you up, trip you up, talk shit behind your back, and not really have your best interests in heart. Now, for whatever the reason is, I don't know if it's jealousy. I don't know if it's their current situation isn't working out the way they expected it to. I don't know if it's they can't garner the attention that they're trying to get, so they want to take shots and get attention from me. I'm not sure the reason. But here's a little backstory. Here's a little context. He doesn't deserve a name drop because I'm not trying to make this nigga famous. I already tried that. So, little backstory. Several years ago, give or take four, when I was living in San Bernardino, California, shout out to Cali, shout out to San Bernardino. I had just finished my 200 collab quest. And if those of you are unfamiliar with the 200 collab quest, it basically is, I did 200 records with up and coming artists and producers from all over the world. I did it in less than a year. 157 of them I did in a row. So 157 days of new music. And I was also the first rapper to pioneer the Facebook Live situation. What happened with Facebook Live is they had a beta version that you could only access if you had a verified account. So because I had a verified account, I was able to go live for an hour and a half. It was timed back then. For an hour and a half, and the regular people who didn't have a verified profile either couldn't get online and go live, and then eventually they opened it up to everybody. And the people, when they did open it up, they were only allowed 30 minutes of live time. So I was doing a whole show where I had people checking out my music. I was actually creating the song, mixing the song, and giving motivational advice all within that hour and a half. And we did it on a daily thing. We called it the 200 collab quest. So it was right after I did that. First rapper in history, by the way, 157 days in a row of new music. It's never been done before. And it's all documented online. Also, so it was around that time, right after I finished that not too long ago. So I figured, okay, the momentum is great. What can I do to give back? So I have my own record label called Intervision Entertainment. So what I decided to do is, since I didn't have a huge budget or any real budget at all to give artists, I decided to scout out some artists, right? Give them an opportunity where they could benefit from all the information that I knew about the music industry, the connections that I had, the marketing and the promotional strategy that I had came up with, and basically use my hype that I had currently garnished from the 200 collab quest to boost up other artists, and we do it as a team, we do it as a crew. I did not require any of these artists to sign anything. See, because I didn't want them to be locked in. You know, I'm a firm believer in, if I don't have finance, because, you know, money pays the bills. You know, popularity is not going to pay your bills per se. It can lead you to the money, but you can't go into a store and say, look, I'm trying to trade this popularity for this car. It's not going to work. So what I did was I invited this guy over. He was one of the artists that I scouted. I invited this guy over. I basically pitched him and said, look, this is what I could do for you. You know, I don't want you to sign anything. All I want you to do is basically rep the brand. And as a team, me, you, and a few other artists that I'm going to be getting together, we could all blow up together, record together, etc., etc. Now, mind you, I had already done verses with a lot of famous people, and I even did verses with people for the 200 collab quest that these people would not even have access to. You know what I mean? So we're talking about local artists that have never had a famous feature, that didn't have any real direction, etc., etc. So I was trying to provide all my professional expertise and help put niggas on. So what happens is, you know, he jumps on board, and eventually I figured, look, first order of business is to send out these records and get everybody to record verses to them. Mind you, I did verses myself for this guy's project as well. Now, at that point in time, I had already done famous verses. I was already buzzing. Most of the people that was involved in the 200 collab quest, especially the artists, they were paying me for verses. So I wasn't charging this guy for my work. I wasn't charging him for my expertise. I wasn't charging him for the verses. I wasn't charging him for nothing. You know what I mean? That's just me being a good guy. Artist development, something that the record labels don't even do anymore. Most people take advantage of artists. They don't try to help them. Unless there's some sort of financial gain for themselves, they do not try to help these people. Me, I'm different. You know, try to look out for niggas. You know how it is. I was raised a little differently. So what happens is, I send out these beats. Couldn't get any verses recorded for any of them. I don't know what the situation was. I don't know if his home situation wasn't stable. His recording situation definitely wasn't stable at the time because he didn't have access to a studio. So I even offered to have him drive up to where I stayed at and record some verses in my studio. Now, needless to say, none of the stuff ever materialized with any of the artists. So what I did was, I utilized all the songs that I already had verses on, because remember, the stuff that I sent to these artists, I already had a verse on them. So all they had to do was drop a verse on top of it. We could have did a hook and we could have had a whole compilation album done within a couple of weeks' time. We could have put it out. We could have ate off the hype. We could have did a lot of things. It would have been very beneficial to everybody's career because we all could have been moving as a unit. See, when I was growing up, that's what inspired me, the Murder Inks. The Bad Boy Records, the Death Row Records, the No Limit Records, where everybody together is moving in the same pace, moving on the same page. See, today it's one artist that reps everything. You don't have a whole bunch of crews. You know, it's just one rapper that's really big and the rest nobody really cares about. See, I wasn't trying to be in that situation. I was trying to basically bring everybody with me at the same time. So back to the story. I sends everybody the music. Nobody ever records anything. So what I decided to do was I said, fuck it. Since nobody's on board, you know, I'll stop focusing on the label shit and I'll start focusing on myself. So the records that I sent out, I turned them into solo records. Instead of them being group compilation records, I turned them into solo records. Excuse me. And it ended up turning out to be the Heart of a Lion, Blood of a King album, which is fucking fire to this day. Recorded in 2018, which is also the album that you guys will get for free by joining my mailing list. It's a fire album. I ended up shooting 5 or 6 music videos off of this album. That's how fire the album was. Pardon the slurping, a nigga's thirsty. That's some water. Okay. So moving forward, never got done, right? I get a word from this guy. He eventually hits me up. You know, we stay in contact. We still chop it up at that point in time. What happens is he's doing his own thing now. Now he has his own thing. So out of nowhere, he, you know, finds a way to record, finds a way to do this, finds a way to get work done, which is cool. So he has his own thing. He tells me the name. He hits me up about the branding and marketing. I give him tips on how to market it. I give him tips on how to brand. I give him tips on, and not only that, I tell him what I'm doing as far as my solo stuff, how I'm marketing, how I'm producing. I'm basically giving this guy gems. Now, in the music industry, this is unheard of. Because what usually happens is when you stop fucking with the crew, you don't get the crew benefits. If you're not part of the crew and you're not part of the team, why the fuck am I giving you information? You're not with us no more. You're not part of the movement. You're doing your own thing. So I'm not supposed to give you the gems to help you keep progressing, to build up your own shit, and I have no stake in it. You see what I'm saying? That's how the game goes. I give you an opportunity. You don't take advantage of the opportunity. Why am I supposed to keep building you when you're with somebody else? Right? Nevertheless, I still give this dude advice, still try to build him up, still give him positive encouragement, still tell him and show him some of the things that I'm doing and refer him to some of the people that I know, right? Because I'm that type of guy. This is how it bites you in the back, ladies and gentlemen. You know, so what happens is, after a while, I don't really hear too much from him. You know, everything is cool. We like each other's posts on social media, etc., etc. And then I make a post about me being a different type of artist and rapping about different things and talking about different subject matter. Now, mind you, this guy, you know, wants to hop in my comment section and say some slick shit. The nigga got the nerve to say, "What do you write about that's different?" Now, first and foremost, I've done features for this nigga. I'm on this nigga's project. He should know what I rap about that's different. He should know the type of person that I am. He should know my body is a work. He should know my work ethic. He should know my subject matter. So, when I saw that comment, right away I was like, yo, this nigga is trying to get a reaction out of me. He's on some slick shit. So at first I was gonna reply. Then I was like, you know what? This is the grown Noah talking. The old Noah would have spazzed the fuck out. This is the grown Noah talking. You know, because right away I'm sensing huge disloyalty from the fact that this nigga, of all niggas, who I invited over to my house, which is a rarity. I rarely invite people over into my public space, has the nerve to ask me what do I write about that's different. Right? So I'm like, yo, this nigga's taking a shot. So I decided, you know, I'm not even gonna indulge in that conversation. The grown-up me is like, you know what, nigga, it's not even worth a discussion. If this, like a long time ago, I would have debated with niggas and I would have went back and forth, but I realized that makes me look like I'm on the same level as niggas. So what I do is I say what I say. Niggas that fuck with it, fuck with it. Niggas that don't fuck with it, they just don't fuck with it, and I don't care. I don't have to explain myself. My resume is tested. My work ethic is incomparable. It's tested. The shit that I've done. We talking about people that barely got a project out. You know what I'm saying? I got 11 albums that's currently available, not including the shit that I did before I was able to create and upload all the shit myself. Let's not count the hundreds and hundreds of features that I did for other artists. My name is on probably 1,000 records right now. You see what I'm saying? So I don't have to explain myself. I have songs and I have worked with legends. I have worked with people that other artists dream of working with. And they'll never get a chance. Some of them passed away. Rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle. There will be people out there that love Nipsey that will never get a Nipsey verse. I was one of the fortunate few that was able to get a Nipsey verse while he was alive. Not only while he was alive, when he was buzzing. So, that's the comment that he makes, right? So I'm like, fuck it, I'm not gonna respond to this shit. It's not worth it. So, a day goes by, right? This nigga has the audacity to go back to my page and back to my comment because he didn't get a response and say, no answer? With a question mark. Still no answer for me because obviously I already made my stance on it. So what he does after that is says, this was a genuine question. Should be easy to answer, right? As Neil deGrasse Tyson says, and in quotations, extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. End of quotations. So basically what this tells me is, this nigga believes that the shit that I said about me rapping about things that other people don't rap about is an extraordinary claim. That it's out of this world, that it's inconceivable, that it's something that is just not possible. And I have to prove on that message that I wrote, that I need to prove it. So the outcome was, I blocked the nigga. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Because I look at it like this. If niggas will do shit to you and try to get under your skin at this level of the game, what the fuck would they do when you're super famous? If niggas will try to shit on you when y'all on the ground coming up and y'all working trying to come up, what will they do if the opportunity is presented when you're famous? This nigga will tell all your fucking secrets. This nigga will send the ops to your crib because he's been there before and knows how to reach you. That's the type of nigga this is. If these type of niggas will dig at you and take shots at you to get a reaction from you, what else would they do? That's my way of thinking. So that being said, that's how I feel. And like I said, this is somebody that I've invited in my home, gave him advice. I've went above and beyond the norm of what I'm supposed to do as an artist, as a rapper, as a record label owner, etc., as an executive. I gave this nigga a shot when wasn't nobody fucking with this guy. Nigga still ain't fucking with him because he hasn't made any progress. But still in all, that just goes to show you the type of person that I am and how the people that you think are your friends, the people that you invest time in, will be the main motherfuckers trying to snake you, shiest you, and take you out in the end. I couldn't believe this. I was like, really? This nigga got the audacity? You know, but how would it make me look as a label owner, right, to go back and bash this nigga on social media when there's videos out there or a video out there of him being part of my team, part of my squad? That would make me look bad as a judge of character. So I decided I'm going to take the high road and not even comment on the shit. But there are certain things that are a fact in this game. Where you live at, they show you the least amount of respect, and those be the people that be out to get you. Your home team, your home base, your friends, your close associates, your homies, it's tried and true that those are the main ones that cause problems. People always get killed in their hood. Nip hustle. Chinks drugs. A lot of XXXTentacion. Killed in their own hood. Killed in their own environment. The same place you trying to rep. The same people you trying to bring up. The same people you trying to inspire. The same people you trying to motivate. Be the main ones that'll be the cause of your downfall. So now you see why artists have a very selfish attitude. Why artists only care about themselves. Why artists don't try to put niggas on once they blow the fuck up. Because you got situations like this. Not only should this nigga have known that my content is completely different, because he was once affiliated with the squad, but he should have enough respect for you not to say this type of shit on a public forum. You see what I'm saying? Because it's casting doubt on whatever I said on my post. Those type of that's a hater move. That's sucker shit. That's the type of shit that haters do. He's casting doubt on the fact that I said that I don't rap about the type of shit that everybody else rap about. And a true fan of my shit knows this to be a fact, that I don't rap about the type of shit that other people rap about. Which is why people gravitate to me. It's not just because of flow patterns. It's not just because of voice. It's because my subject matter. Because my content. You know. So that's my story for today. That is story time, ladies and gentlemen. This is a personal experience that happened to me. Make sure you stop by NoahJonesNews.com and check out some of my merchandise. Check out some of my albums. If you want to support it, support it. Don't forget to support this podcast. This podcast is called Today in Hip Hop and can be found on all streaming services. Spotify, Apple Music. I prefer Radio Public. You know. But yeah, that's story time. Today in Hip Hop, episode 9. I love y'all. And remember, keep a close eye. Keep a close eye on the niggas in your circle. You know. Double check and see if they really for you or against you. Because this is the type of shit right here that artists, as they become successful or have already achieved some type of success, we're going to go through this. You're going to go through this. So remember this. Try to learn from this lesson. And if you're listening to this, you know, and you're not a rapper, you're just a fan of music in general, try to understand why we don't put niggas on. Try to understand why, you know, we are selfish when we out here making all this money and we not bringing up the people around us. You see what I'm saying? This is a lesson learned for not only me, but for you guys as well. I appreciate y'all's support. Once again, it's your boy Noah Jones. Love y'all. Check out NoahJonesNews.com. Peace.